This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This video is for Calculus 3. It is the first video of talking about three-dimensional coordinate systems, and in this video we'll be covering the Cartesian coordinate system. Throughout the course in Calculus 3, we will be studying vectors, surfaces, functions, motion, derivatives, and integrals in three dimensions. The first unit of the course uses Cartesian coordinates, also known as rectangular coordinates. Cartesian coordinates are written with an ordered triple, parentheses x, y, z. The x, y, and z axes are mutually orthogonal, meaning that they are at 90 degrees to each other. Traditionally, we draw this with the z-axis pointing up, the y-axis, the positive y-axis pointing to the right, and the positive x-axis pointing diagonally left, as if it were coming out of the page towards us. And again, these axes are each orthogonal or perpendicular to each other, so we can put those little right angle boxes. The origin, 0, 0, 0, is the point where all three axes intersect. The first octant is the one in which all variables are positive. We do not number the other octants like we do with quadrants in two dimensions. We only label the first octant where all are positive. To plot a point in the Cartesian coordinate system in three dimensions, think of a box with the base defined by the x and y values and the height defined by the z value. In this picture, we're plotting the point x, y, z, and we can see that we come out x on the x-axis and y on the y-axis, and then use those values to make a rectangle in the xy plane, so that creates the base of our box. Now from the corner of that rectangle, the point xy0, we go up z in the z direction. And so we end up with a three-dimensional box, and the point xyz is at the corner of that box. So let's practice with example 1. We want to plot the points 3, 5, 2, and 3, negative 3, negative 4 on separate grids. So the first thing I want to do is draw my grids. So I draw two separate grids, and we want to make sure that we label our axes. So I put the x on the left-hand axis, the y on the right-hand axis, and the z on the axis that's pointing upward. So focusing on the first point, 3, 5, 2, I want to come out 3 in the x direction, so I come out along the x-axis 3. I want to go 5 in the y direction, so I mark off 5 on the y-axis, and I use those points to make a rectangle in the xy plane. So that the corner of that rectangle is the point 3, 5, 0, because I haven't gone anywhere in the z direction yet. Now I want to go up 2 in the z direction, so I mark off 2 on the z axis, and I use that to create a three-dimensional box. So I also go up 2 in the z direction from the point 3, 5, 0, and now that point on the corner of the box is the point 3, 5, 2. Now when you actually start plotting points, you don't have to always draw the box, but it can be helpful when you're first learning to visualize it this way. Now on the second point, 3, negative 3, negative 4, we come out 3 in the x direction, and now we're going to go to negative 3 in the y direction, so I draw my negative axes, so it's like the negative x-axis is going into the page, and the negative y-axis is going to the left. So I come out 3 in the negative y-direction, so to the left of the origin, and I use the point x equals 3, y equals negative 3, to make a rectangle in the xy plane. So that gives me the point, the corner of the rectangle, is 3, negative 3, 0, and now I want to go down 4 in the z-direction. So the negative z-axis goes straight down. I mark off negative 4, and I use that to create my three-dimensional box, with the lower corner being the point 3, negative 3, negative 4. Now, I could have accomplished the same thing by just making myself a little path where I go out 3 in the x direction, negative 3 in the y direction, so left 3, and then from there down 4. So that will accomplish the same thing. That's how we plot points in three dimensions in the Cartesian coordinate system.